Been in the city.
The funniest thing I saw today was one of the tickers on CNN saying that Mayor Giuliani was urging New Yorkers to go to the theater. Okay, Stu, get rid of it.
Stuart, get rid of the camera. We're gonna get in shit.
Okay!
Well, we're not that close.
Well, we're close enough. They've got cameras trained on us already, sharpshooters.
Pitches in high in the air to shallow center. Willie Harris comes on in. He's there to make the catch, and there are two of them.
It's 4:42 in the morning. Stuart!
See, no good has come of this camera so far.
It stopped us at the border,
detained
it embarrassed
the border
us
for
in the car.
30 minutes.
It's impeding on our good night of sleep.
Diesel fuel from the plane?
Some, not all, not too much. Stuff like this, the smell you smell here now usually work from the trucks and all that. Mask, buy yourself a little bottle of Vicks, put it underneath your nose so you can tolerate a little bit of smell. That's about it. I smoke a cigar.
Down tonight because I wanted to see just what it looked like beyond the television images.
You know, it's kind of superficial when you hear it on the media, but this is something that just can't be described. And you know, the sorrow that you have and all the different feelings that are just come forth and seeing it, it's kind of a not a closure, but it's a kind of a feeling of a very, very, you're part of it, you know, and you're some way that you can express your sympathies and appreciation. You see a policeman, you put your thumbs up and say, great, you know, good job, and just you have compassion for everybody, so.
Most of the people have been very understanding that there was a tragedy here, and there's going to be some inconveniences, and they're abiding by it. Well, one life lost in any department is too many.
Been down yet, or is this your first day?
Yeah, well, this is the first time we came down.
Yeah.
So we live uptown on the Upper East Side, and it feels like sort of life is normal.
What you also notice is the silence. These streets are normally bustling with traffic. Now they're pedestrian walkways. Was it your recording?
Apart from thousands of passers-by shuffling for a glimpse of what's become known as Ground Zero, the streets of Lower Manhattan remain relatively empty. In contrast, Yankee Stadium's expected to be filled to overflowing Sunday afternoon for a mass memorial service in honor of the police officers, firefighters, and other rescue workers killed when the World Trade Center came crashing. It's incredibly distracting. Hang on.
What you also notice is just how quiet New York has become. Normally these streets are congested with traffic, but today they're deserted. But just a few blocks away from Ground Zero and the Curious is, But just a few blocks away from Ground Zero and the onlookers, there's nobody. Manhattan has turned into a ghost town.
In New York, I found a friend to drown out the other voices. Voices on a cell phone, voices from home, voices of the hard cell, voices down a stairwell in New York. Just got a place in New York. In New York, summers get hot. Well into the hundreds. You can't walk around the block without a change of clothing. Hot as a hairdryer in your face. Hot as a handbag in a can of mace. New York, I just got a place in New York. New York.
In New York you can forget, forget how to sit still. Tell yourself you won't stay in, but it's down to alphabet.
lot of people buying World Trade Center pictures?
Yes.
Yeah, they're selling?
Yes, I said it.
George Washington Bridge sign is indicating 95 South.
Well, I can get you off of Manhattan after that. I don't know.
After that, it's out of your hands.
Okay.